You curled out, little sis. You cute. You cute. You were looking at me like. Hey, 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 everyone. To all my flower power, flower petals. I'm trying to get like something I can say for y'all, but regardless, it is Iris Olivia. And she's back with another review. So guess what, guys? It's mail time. It's mail time, mail time, mail time. Yeah. Mail time. So y'all know what it means when I get a package and it's mail time. That means it's another review. So this review is another hair review, actually. Get my scissors because we're about to open this package on it. This hair is for all my natural girls out there, I got a wig for you. So this is a wig from Finger Comber. So I actually found out about Finger Comber through one of my friends, Daria DiLolo. She was the one that put me onto it. So I was like, let me get my first wig from her. And she had express shipping. So I was like, hello, I'm going to get that. And it's a great price. But just PS, these are like synthetic wigs. So don't be out here trying to like heat that up, boy. Like it's supposed to be natural and it's supposed to stay natural in its curly state, okay? So anyways, I'm gonna open the box. So it's actually super cute. They have this little tag in here. I remember from my last wig I got. So the last wig I got from them was huge. I loved it. It was the elongated curl something. I'll also link that to my previous wig. But I also wanted to get a smaller one because the other one just got too big. I had it for over a year and a half. And I was like, I think I got my good wear out of it. Like, I think I'm good. So it's time to get another one when it's a little bit smaller. I'm struggling to get this out of the box. Oh gosh. Whew. And here's a return label, just in case emergencies. Hold up, this is not a return label. This is just, that took some wind out of me. This is just a packaging label to let you know what's in here. So I got the curl out little sister unit in chestnut black. Shout out to the 1B. But that's what I got on here. So I ordered this, that's one thing. So I ordered this the 21st, came a month later, and that's with express shipping. I'm just gonna leave that there for you. It's like took a month to get here from order date to ship date. So just know that it ain't no quick 1-2 turnaround. But anyways, oh, that's small. She cute though. So, but this okay box with this little bow.
Sure.
All right, y'all ready? Drum roll, please. Oh, wait. Wait, no. What was that song that they had? It doesn't matter. Cause she's here. Black wrapping paper. I'm gonna reuse this to recycle. If y'all came from a home, your grandma said, give me that tissue paper back. I need that for your next present. For next year. I'm gonna fold this sucker on up. Okay, she's just in here. She's just in here sitting up. So let's see. It don't really smell like anything. That which is really good, to be like so honest. You'd rather it not smell like nothing than smell like Cheetos. But it smells kind of good, actually. I take that back. It smells like someone conditioned it, and it smells really good. So, y'all, this wig is super light. I mean, look at that. Super duper light. So how the construction looks on the inside. Again, since I've had a finger comb, I had one of these wigs before, so I kind of already knew what to expect. But just for all you all, for sure. So it's going to come with two clips in the top and in the bottom. or wait a minute, is this the top and that's the bottom? I'm pretty sure this is the top because it's more full up here. So the top is going to be where you actually have your, the statement of, yay, this is who it is. This is the top is going to be a much wider one, which makes a lot more sense. And the bottom one's going to be a little bit smaller. It's literally just wefted hair onto an actual cap. There is no lace, which is great for our natural girls because if you want to braid your hair all the way back, like how mine look under here, you just pop this on to be out and be on your way. So, the curls look so nice, y'all. I mean, look at that. So no wonder they say braid it back up and put some perm rods at the ends and put hot water back on here. So the only thing I learned from my previous unit that I got from them was once these uncoil, it's like whatever they use to coil this, it gets... What's the word I'm looking for? Sorry, I'm watching my neighbors out here as I record in front of a window. It starts to get, what is it when you put edge control on and it gets flaky? There we go. So the end starts to get a little flaky and I wasn't the biggest fan of that because I was like, what are they putting on this to hold it in these little curling patterns? I'm trying to put it on the white background. Like, what is it they're putting out here for these little curl things? Because whatever it is starting to cake up, not even cake up, flake out. So I thought it was kind of weird and I would like want to brush them out, but then I'm brushing the little curl, the in out. So that was annoying. So hopefully that won't happen again. But that's just a PS. If you do see that on your unit, that's what's going on. Whatever they used to hold this little curly thing, is starting to flake off. But right now when I look at it, like I don't see anything that would make it look like the little ringlets to make this, see, there's no like residue on here to make this seem like this is going to flake off. So I don't know. Anyways, I just want to give a shout out to how light this unit is though. All right, what else do I want to tell you guys about this? That is about it. So this, there's no adjustable straps in here, y'all. So however big, however small, however peanut-like your head is, mine, ain't nothing you can do about it. It is what it is. Slide it back, pull it up, let your whole head cover it, whatever. But I also would suggest wearing a black cap underneath this. I know that a lot of us, when we have our regular wigs on, we put one that's like flesh tone or brown underneath our wigs to make it blend a little bit more for our part. I would not suggest doing that for these wigs because at any moment, the wind blow wrong. Ooh, who this? Your fingers and your scalp. So that, don't be like me because I did that one time. I wore a light, this smells really good. I'm off topic. I wore a flesh colored cap and when that wind blew, my friend was like, girl, no. Don't do that no more. And I never did. So I'm about to get my black cap and put it on real quick so I can show you guys how this actually looks on. But I'm really excited because, again, this is much smaller than my other one. And I'm going to get my other one too so y'all can kind of see the difference in how big it is from the elongated to the little sister curl out unit. So I'll be right back. So y'all, I don't know where all my black caps went. So whatever. Anyways, I went ahead and grabbed the other unit. So this is how big it is. Like, look how big this is compared to this one. Then look also at the texture of it. So this one's a lot bigger, but I've also had this one for like a year and a half. So this is beyond its expiration date. But I still love it. And you can see like where these ends had the curls. It's now just turned into a big ball of a mess. And you can see that right here. Just turned into a big knot. Some of it at the very ends still have some of them, but I'm gonna pop this one on real quick so you can see how big it is. This one right here also had straps, so if you look inside, this one right here has straps in here, and the other one does not. So just PS, and know that this one does and the other one did not. So I'm gonna pop this on real quick so you can see. Okay, she's back. I mean, look how big this is. Look how big this is. So, ooh, y'all, this is a great frame. Okay, but anyway, so I kind of would pull this to the side like this and wear it kind of like open. Or I would just kind of turn this to the side and wear it like this. Which again, I still absolutely love, but it just needs to be detangled. And I don't know if I have the patience to do that. This wig is humongous. It's got a lot going on. And I just don't like, because it's synthetic hair, once you try to pull something out or detangle it, it'll like get straight. And I don't have the patience. But now knowing that I can like twist this up and put it in some hot water and recurl it, I really may consider doing that because I really do like this wig a lot of how like big it is for some shoots and stuff like that. But yeah, but you see how you can just put it on your head and you don't even need to have any leave out because it's so big. All right, so y'all ready to put, so again, this is the elongated, and it's much longer than this, but of course it's a year and a half old of synthetic hair and now it's sticking. So I do need to detangle this and recurl it, but you couldn't really tell if you don't look too hard. Time to put this baby on. You're gonna see how small, much smaller this is compared to this one. Okay, excuse me while I look into the mirror and figure this out. So can y'all like see my hair, my braids underneath here? Not really. Maybe back here you can. Maybe, can y'all see that? I don't know, but anyways, let's figure this out. So the clip, I'm just gonna smooth right into there. This is actually kind of big. Y'all know my head is really little. So I'm gonna have to use these clips in the back and clips in the front, like for real. So do I want like a side something? Like what am I trying to do here? Okay, this is cute. See how much smaller this is? Like, I feel like I honestly have nothing on my head. That's how lightweight this is. And I like don't want to like comb it out. I don't want to touch it because the ends, the little curls at the ends are like super cute. This is also great, like if I wanted to kind of pull this up for whatever reason.
So y'all, I would only suggest pulling it back if you are gonna have leave out so that it will cover those edges and that raw edge will not just be sticking out. So just PS going forward, again, I would only pull this back if you are gonna have leave out around your perimeter.
If I just shake my hair out, what's it gonna do? Where's it gonna land? All right, looks like it's only gonna be good if it's flippable. All right, let's try to put this back again.
Bro, what is you doing?
Look very good. Try to get these bobby pins out, but it's whatever. Okay, this way is cute. It really is just really finding out where you want to part the hair at and figure that out. One of the fun. I had to take these out. Let's try that. Only reason why I'm not showing, it just looks like it's been upside down. But I like this more. So this is really short up here compared to like down here. But this looks like the wig is upside down, don't it? Or y'all like it like this? So if I were to shake it out and it just lands, what do we do? Okay, this is workable. This is actually workable upside down though. Or maybe I don't have upside down and I just wrong. Regardless, this is actually kind of cute. It's almost like a mullet right now. Y'all, the reason why I keep up my head from the side every time I take my wig off is because my braids is dusty. And I don't have my black cap on underneath here. All right, so she turned it back the other way. I'm liking this now that I've like played with it a little bit. And just why is this flipped the wrong way? Okay. I mean, this is definitely doable, y'all. What is this? If I want to go to the side. Sorry, y'all, I'm watching myself because I just don't know how this looks. That's doable. That's the way. Just a little bit edges right here.
Slick those edges down. Slick them down.
Oh, that looks really natural, but that's not even my hair. But that's cute. We gonna leave that. This is cool. Okay. Other side, what we got, what we got, what we got. What do we have over here? Oh, got it on my nose. Felt like it was a bug. Like, you know how you get like gnats flying around you? That's how that little curl felt in my nose. All right, maybe not to the other side. Ow. It's not bad. I can work this, y'all. Like, I'm dedicated to making this work. Actually, right now, this looks really good. So, end of the day, it's gonna fall. Or is it gonna land? Shake, shake, shake. Up and let it land. Okay. I want you just doing that. Shake it out and let it land wherever it wants to land at. So, I'm gonna just go ahead and just finish this up. What? And why? Does it just keep sitting there? But again, this is like, again, this is really big for me. This unit is pretty hefty. It's just really, like, since it doesn't have the, literally even clips, but the adjustable strap in the back, it's a little tougher. Me with my little head. But yeah, so anyways, really just figure out your own style with this wig. I, again, love how lightweight these wigs are. I love how natural these wigs look. And I really love that this is made by us for us. Okay? Just saying. And this texture is truly the texture how some of our African-American sister hairs look. Like, for real, this is how our hair looks. So when you just wanna be able to have a protective style, a quick one where you're like, let me just do a braid down real quick, flat twist your hair out, whatever, pop your wig on, this is a great wig to pop on and let it just kind of lay or land wherever it wants to land. And I mean, you can do whatever you want. You can put some clips in the side, not clips, but you can put some bobby pins over here to help hold the hair to a side you want. You can do like a faux bang. There's just endless possibilities that you can do with these wigs. Of course, with time restraint, I just don't have the time. And in another video, I will just be styling it. But right now, this is really an unboxing of the wig and kind of going through what exactly this wig is. But I really do like this. Like, I've always liked a lot of their wigs, and I think that they are an awesome company. And just know that the cons are, it did take a while to get here. They said they had a lot going on and a lot of shipping for whatever it was. I guess all of us were like, we need a new wig, let's go on Fingercomber. I don't know, but I didn't too much mind. It wasn't a rush. I was trying to get it in for a certain time frame. It didn't get here. I was all right, I'll be okay. My other wig was great, worked out perfectly. So again, it's just awesome. So I do love this wig. I have a couple photo shoots coming up. I'm thinking I probably may just wear this and keep my natural hair braided for time being and just go ahead and rock this as is and be like, she cute and she natural. Thanks. But I like it. I really like this wig. So maybe my next video will be, let me know if y'all want a styling tutorial on this wig. And then I'm probably gonna try to even detangle the other wig. That could be a whole nother video. I'm trying to figure that out. But let me know if that's what you guys wanna see. But I just really want to give y'all an unboxing of what, you know, Fingercomber wigs are. Finger combing out, but I don't want to let it touch this hair because it's just so, and look at it, y'all. up. Long story short, we're going to make this a really easy one because it's just an unboxing. But I am going to turn around so you can see the length of where this lands on me. And y'all know I'm 5'10". Okay, she didn't fall off. And I didn't fall off the chair. But you see... So, I need to get another chair because I'm just too comfortable in this chair with my knees up. But yeah, so I like how it just kind of lands wherever it wants to land and it actually looks nice. So, just PS, do your own thing. Figure out how to style it. Figure out what works for you with your hair. But it smells good. It looks cute. It's whatever. You can leave the perimeter out. Hold it up. Put this up. Like even this one, you know, like a little bun thing at the top. Would be really cute if you had your perimeter left out, but mine is not because I was wearing my other wig. So yeah, but just like shake it out, figure out how it wants to land and what it wants to do. This wig has a mind of its own, so just let it do its thing. See, it landed pretty good. So anyways, I'm gonna wrap this video up. It's been great, guys. Again, stay blessed, stay prayed up, put that fence around you, a positive energy. Meditate, talk to God, like literally, just stay awesome. Like literally there's so much negative energy out here that it's not even funny. And be able to surround yourself by friends and family and what makes you happy. I was told that whenever you have like negative thoughts or something comes in your head that's, you know, not the most positive thing, replace that with something that you're grateful for. Like something comes in your head and you're like, oh, I feel better about myself. Talk about what you're grateful for. Think about what you're grateful for and replace that negative thought with not only a positive thought, but remembrance that you are good, that you are blessed, that you have been surrounded by awesome people, and you will continue to be A-okay. Don't let those negative energy or thoughts rule your mind, because let me tell you, my mom told me this when I was very little. Fear and faith cannot occupy the same space. Light is way brighter than darkness, right? So when the light comes in, swallows the dark, and God got you. All right, guys, with that note, she gonna flip over here one more time. She gonna flip over there one more time. She gonna flip over here one more time. In this.